Hey everyone, so in the last video lecture we started handling exceptions, and it is important to learn about their management since most exceptions are not handled by programs and they result in error messages. So we'll talk about that. First, let's pick up where we left off. So I hope now you know how to use try and except blocks. Today we're going to include one more block, finally block. And we use keyword finally for it, and also we'll make use of else with except. So first I'll show you how you can use else with except. I'm going to take the same very example I used yesterday. Okay, so yesterday I took this example of inputting a number, taking a number at runtime. So I'm going to use that runtime, that addition example, and I will write these few statements. So I'll get the first number, and then I'm going to get the second number B. Okay, and then I'll add these two numbers, except print. So if I don't get integer, I usually enter alphabet to show an error. I would like to print integer was expected, else print well done. I'll save it. Program example, and I'm going to run it. 8 and G. It says integer was expected. As you can see, usually else is coupled with if, but in here it is coupled with except. So it's like if there is an exception, if try throws an exception, except the except block. If there is no exception, control goes to else block. Okay, so this is how you can use else with except. Of course, you don't have to, because it will work fine if you don't use else. But if you have any program exercises or you want to use it, in many cases, sometimes you feel like using it, you can use except with else. This is how you can use it. Okay, so let's see the use of finally block now. And as I told, keyword used is finally. And I'm going to modify this program only by adding finally to the end of the program, and it shows the finally block shows the final execution that is a statement to be printed or an action to be taken by modifying a variable or something. So fundamentally, this finally block will be executed at the end whether there was an exception or not. So I can write a finally here. So let's say I would say print. And by the way, if you are using else, you can still use a print statement here. So I can say, let's say, end of the program, and I will run it. So I'll enter first number T, and right, integer was expected, end of the program. So this is how this except and else works. If except block was executed, else will not be executed. If else is executed, except will not be executed. I'll run it again, and this time we'll try to execute else block. So I'll enter two integers. So this time else was executed, and then it says end of the program. So this final statement is not associated with any of these, right? These are the blocks that we're working on, and this statement is independent, you know. And this is the statement that I'm going to write in finally block, because this is the independent statement. So independent statements are to be included in finally block if you ever want to use finally block. Okay, now if I run it, for h, so we have integer was expected and end of the program finally gets executed. Next time run this module, 6, 8, well done, end of the program. So irrespective of the fact whether there was an exception or not, finally will be executed, and I don't have to use this else also. It's not mandatory. So if I run it like this, it will still be executed. So 7k, integer was expected, end of the program. And if there is no exception, it will be something like this, 7, 8, end of the program, right? So finally gets executed when either there is no exception or there is an exception, right? This is how you can use finally block. Now these are some of the exceptions. All of these are built-in exceptions, and I forgot to include division by zero here, and I will make a quick program with that to make you understand how these exceptions are to be handled. Okay, so I'll make a quick program, very simple program. A equals to 9, B equals to 0, C equals to A divide by B. Okay, save it and run it. Alright, as you can see, this is the error here. This is actually the exception that I forgot to include there. Right? You can see zero division error. This is an exception. Zero division error is the name of an inbuilt exception. So it is shown on the screen, but it is not handled. Similarly, these are some of the inbuilt exceptions, and there are so many inbuilt exceptions like these, and they are not handled. They are shown on the screen whenever there is an error associated. You can handle them. That is what exception handling is. And let us handle this division by zero exception. And for handling built-in or inbuilt exceptions, you should know the right name for that exception. For example, in Python, this specific runtime exception, this one, division by zero exception, or this division by zero, this particular specific exception or runtime error is called zero division error. And keep in mind that it is case sensitive, so be mindful of uppercase and lowercase letters. Okay, so it's like Z is capital, D is capital, and E is capital. So let us now handle this exception. And what we're going to do in this program is learn two things. So you will learn how to handle a specific exception, and you will also get to see what happens when you have multiple except blocks. The reason multiple except blocks are used is because we don't always know the kind of exception is going to be there in the program. So you can write except block for all the kinds that you suspect could be there in the program. And I'm going to use this, I'm going to use division by zero, and I will also use this value error exception to show you how you can handle these exceptions. And I'm also going to use one empty, I would call it empty except. So to handle an exception, first we need to throw it. So I'll use these statements in try block. Okay. All right. I'm going to write the first exception, that is value error. And I want that if try block throws this inbuilt exception, instead of showing an error, show me this particular message. And it's not like you have to write a specific message. You can perform some function or like modify the integer or something. You can change the value or something, right? So I'm going to print a simple message. Let's say this is value error. And if this is not the exception, then it could be 0 division error. And for that case, it should print this is division by 0, or if it is not value error or division, 0 division error, I will print. You can write anything. I don't know the kind of exception that has been thrown, or maybe just enter a valid number, maybe for division. Alright. Now I will run this program. And as you can see, this is division by 0. So this is division by 0. So once I run this program, an exception is thrown by try block. It goes to first block, and this is the first block and it is not value error exception. So it goes to second block, 0 division except error, and we found the right exception, so it will not go to third block. Otherwise, if it cannot find the correct exception, it will go to except block with nothing mentioned there, that is the last block, right? So this is how you can handle exceptions, and this is how you can handle inbuilt exceptions. And this is it for today's lecture video. Students have asked for time to work on a few exercises on exceptions, and I think you should take your time and keep practicing. I'm posting programming videos every Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday. So I will see you next Monday. If you have any doubt, any video suggestions, you can always comment in the comment sections below. Thank you so much, and I'll see you next Monday. Till then, take care.